Okay, I'm trying to put together a few of the features that we learned this week. First of all would be the sum count. So if we hit in here and put equals sum open parentheses, now we can select the items that we want to sum. So we'll start with this cell. Another thing we learned is hit shift control down, and we can come all the way down to the set. But because I have a break in these numbers, it's not going all the way down, as you can see. So we learned another trick to take care of that. So we'll teach you that. So that's our sum function. So that's everything that's in that row. Now we want to count that row, but we also learned how to whatever they call it, name the set. So I'm gonna come down here and I'm gonna select all of that. I'm gonna come to this square. I'm gonna call it budget. BUDDT, hit enter. Okay, so now those cells have a name. So I want to count those cells and I'm going to hit equals count. You can see these cell populate. You can actually just double click on there and it will start the function. And if I want to count the budget row, I'll just hit budget, as you can see here, and I'll double click on that. Hit enter. So that tells me I've got 36 items in that row, but because I have some blanks there, we don't have all of them. We'll find that out by doing count A. That's how we can count things that aren't numbers. So again, we just start typing equals count, and you can see the count A function populates here. I'll double click on that, and it says, what do we want to count? I'll click on here, control shift down. That's going to take me down to the bottom of the set. I'll hit enter. That tells me we have 42 cells there, and you can see there's a discrepancy between my count and my count A. So we're going to count blank here. So I'm going to put equals count again. You can see count blank is populated. Click on that. We want to do the budget cells. I'll double click there, hit enter. So there's 6 blank cells in here, and if you get the 36 that it counted plus the 6 blank ones, that gives us the 42 that we have here. Okay, we also learned about the mean, which to find that out, you hit equals average, AV average, that pops up as well. Double click on that. We want to average out the budget cell, so we're going to double click on budget, hit enter. So our average of all of the items in the amount category here are 243. If we want the median, we just start equals start typing and you'll see it self-populate there. So we'll double click on that. We want to use the same point, so we'll use the budget. Double click on that, hit enter. So the median, which is the middle number of the set, is 110. The mode, which will be whatever occurs the most, we can hit equals mode, start typing. You see, we get a couple pop up here. We'll do singular, I think we'll do that one. And we're going to use the budget set. Double click on budget, hit enter. So 200 is the number that occurs the most in that set. We also learned about variance, which I don't think I understand very well because that's a really big number. But so if we hit the variance S, I believe is the one that we were using. And then same, we're going to use that number set right here. We'll double click on that and hit entered. And then we did our standard deviation, which again, you start typing equals STD. You can see the standard dev populates up there. We're going to hit this S one. We're going to use our budget name and hit enter. And that's our standard deviation. So those are just a few things that we learned this week that I like. Thanks for watching.